Fahmy's is itself an ancient craft, and she learned it the old-fashioned way. Nearly 40 years ago, in the alleys of Cairo's famous Khen El Khalili market, where tourists and locals still throng amid the crafts.
Fahmy's pioneering use of gold, silver, and stones makes her one of the Arab world's preeminent jewelry designers. She got her start in the late 60s as the first woman to apprentice in Egypt's jewelry district. While working for the government, she started creating her own designs in her spare time. Today, Fahmy has more than 180 employees.
Located in the suburbs of Cairo, there a variety of traditions are preserved, including the three-tiered system of trainee, trainer, and master craftsmen, who practice techniques that Fahmy says were in danger of disappearing. Every piece handmade of gold, silver, semi-precious, and precious stones, and often adorned with calligraphy, a passage from the Quran, or a line from one of Fahmy's favorite writers, Khalil Gibran.
Because I like both things, Gibran words and the jewelry. I always connect things.
All aimed at commerce, yes, and Fahmy has opened stores in Europe and wants to begin to sell in the U.S., but also a sense of preserving a craft and culture.
We take the level of crafts in jewelry up. So this is, I think, I help my society in that.
At London Fashion Week, all eyes are usually on the clothes. But the Arab and Islamic-influenced brooches, bracelets, necklaces, and rings adorning these models are also getting attention. The jewelry, a collaboration between fashion powerhouse Julian McDonald and Egyptian jewelry designer Azza Fahmy.
I really like the craft and the romance and the skill that goes into the pieces. So that teamed up with my sense of high-octane glamour and my London high-living twist is a great mix and a contrast, and that's what I like.
Azza Fahmy Jewellery has gotten international media attention, but don't, as one London paper did, call the catwalk collection designer bling.
You know, beautiful piece of jewelry, it talks to you like a good painting.